Hey, any fish? 27th of October, 2017. And there is once again just a barrage of just wonderful things that I'm being shown. And of course, you know, I gotta keep my stuff together here to try and share it with you, you know what I mean? But I just was checking my headlines, you know, and this article popped out. World wine production just hit a 56-year low. That's not even the worst part. Okay, 56, that comes into play. The 11, so forth. But you see, he's purging the fruit from the vine, right? Global wine production. And how the world looks at wine is really quite sad. Wine is not what the world, that's just dirty, fermented skins, you know what I mean? But anyway, you go on, and 56 years back, 56 years ago, is 1961. The perfect upside down and backwards representation of itself, the 69, 91, 61, so you got the 69 in between the two pillars, if you will. And it just goes on and on. All these numbers and stuff. I mean, this one here really got me. Italy, the top wine country, you know, 23% less. Like a purge. Like, I don't know how else to explain it. The same exact things that I've been seeing since this image came in front of me. The dividing, the harvest, the wheat, the tares. I mean, it goes all the way to the train there. Remember the sheep and the goats? Wheat, tares, sheep, goats. It just, all of it is just like bang, bang, bang. All in front of me, constantly. And so this article, I'll link it, but it goes on and just talks about how much money that they've lost. And let's not forget, you know, some of the biggest wine country in the world there in California just burnt up in a fire that no one can explain. And half of the reason why the grapes failed in Italy and whatnot too is because of a heat wave named Lucifer. Okay? I mean, it's crazy. And the world just keeps doing what they do. And I can't help but share this. The world thinks there's a silver lining, though. Because beer consumption has swelled. That's how backwards and upside down the world is. You know, it's great news for spirit makers. You know what I'm saying? So it all comes back to this. This is what everything is showing me. So I wanted to look up some scripture, right? On the wine, on the grape, on the vineyards, on all of it. You know what I mean? So I pull up Bible Gateway. This is the verse of the day that popped up, which is just a very powerful verse. For the word of God is quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit. Again, talking about the dividing and of the joints and marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart. Well, you see this word right here, piercing. And it comes right back to this. When I looked up the gematria that led us to everything else we've seen, this middle one was the only one I didn't touch on. We talked about the 322, the Genesis, and the 23 and the 46, the separation. But this 1338, out of all the verses in the Bible that could pop up, on the automatic pop-up on Bible Gateway, it's Hebrews 4:12, where this version of the word piercing is the only place in the entirety of the Bible that it is used. Means to reach through, penetrate, pierce. And if you read this verse, I mean this chapter rather, you will just totally understand where we are at in time, because it's talking about coming to the rest. All right? And it goes on and on. I mean, I do search out verses about the vineyards. And sure enough, Matthew 20, about the 11th hour, the workers that he gets in the 11th hour, and they still get the penny, and all the other workers that were there all day are, you know, all discord, and you see what I'm getting at? He talks about the last unto the first. It's just crazy, you guys. I'm telling you, it's all here. It's all here. The vine, the Father is the husbandman. It's just amazing stuff. So that's primarily what I wanted to show with you guys, is how on earth do I go from that without it being the continuation of this same message? That is complete and utter verification for me. Plain and simple, we are in those times, and you need to seek with every ounce of heart that you can muster. If you do not know Christ, then you do not know the truth, and you do not know the times you are in. Look around. You like what you see? Well, then seek the truth, because it will set you free. The world will lead you to death. That's it. So, I hope this helps somebody once again, and peace and grace to you all. Any fish?
Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God,